We have Shweta and Radhika, who are project associates working in Dsource. Okay, both are graphic designers. They've learned to do a lot of research, you know, do analysis, explorations, and convert that finally into products. So they have been behind two of our tools, the elements of design and the color tool. I think they're going to start with the color tool. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. So our first tool is the color tool. So the fundamentals of color tool has been developed with a view of educating beginner designers about the use and importance of color. We have strived to collect many concepts regarding the use of color under one roof. Our approach of engaging students here is through interactive tasks and experiences on webspace. Along with theory, we also have identified a few applications and plan on adding more. So let's have a look at our tool. Fundamentals of Color is a design learning tool developed by IDC IIT Bombay. This is an interactive web space where students and aspiring designers can learn about color, its attributes, and multiple applications. The tool is divided into three chapters, first of which is Color Overview. This chapter contains color basics and color schemes. Color Basics brushes up your introductory knowledge of color, while Color Schemes covers the six basic and widely used color combinations or schemes. Using color schemes in your designs makes it cohesive. Not using a color scheme may result in your design looking dull or mismatched, simply not unified even if composed well. Our second chapter is Color Attributes. This chapter contains technical aspects of color such as temperature and contrast, hue saturation and value, and color and its varied contexts. Temperature is the impact of cold and warm colors on a visual. A simple example is warm colors like red, yellow, and orange used to depict the day, and cool colors like blue, green, and violet used to depict the night. Contrast includes the seven types of color contrasts identified by Johannes Itten, a Swiss expressionist painter and designer. These seven contrasts are contrast of hue, lightness and darkness, cold and warm, complementary contrast, simultaneous contrast, contrast of saturation, and contrast of extension. The sub-chapter Hue, Saturation, and Value includes information on pure color, which is hue, on darkness and lightness of a color, which is value, on brightness or dullness of a color, which is saturation. It also has an exercise designed to test your knowledge after learning these concepts. The next sub-chapter, Color and its varied contexts, include color in nature, psychology, emotions, and culture. Color in nature gives you an experience of naturally occurring colors. Color plays an effect on the human mind. Color psychology thus takes you through the reasons why specific colors are used for certain purposes. Color and emotions tell you which colors are related to what emotions. We see a duality in color here, as opposing emotions are represented by the same color. Color and culture contains color connotations associated with different cultures around the world. Along with studying color, applying that knowledge becomes necessary for one's learning process. Storytelling is one of the color tool's applications. Color is a powerful form of non-verbal communication. We see storytelling mediums like films, animated, as well as live action using this property of color to their advantage. The absence and use of color can add layers to the stories being told, engaging, enticing, and surprising the audience along the way. Associative color includes use of color for association of a character or an idea. Whereas transitional color includes using colors as cues to emotions. Moods, change in settings, and values. We also have examples of stories, live-action films, animated films, comic books, from which one can learn more about the role of color in storytelling. Branding and packaging is the next color application. Color is the first element of design that we notice about a brand or its packaging. Choosing colors to represent a brand becomes a very important decision. Hence, choosing a color for your brand should be a careful choice and not an arbitrary one. In the branding and packaging application, we can study color's effects on human psychology and how we perceive a brand because of its colors. The fundamentals of color tool can be a demonstrator tool for teachers to show the scope of color. For beginner design students, it can play a role of developing color sensitivity to produce high quality and informed design. It can also be used as a self-study tool or a revision tool. You can experience this tool on dsource.in or on the Dsource app available on the Play Store as well as the App Store. Happy learning! So to conclude, the fundamentals of color tool has been designed iteratively with feedback from design students and practicing designers. Our vision for this tool is that of being a useful aid to design educators. Thank you. I request Shweta to take you through the next tool, which is Elements of Design. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. The Elements of Design tool is developed with the intention of making basic concepts of design easy to understand and fun to learn. Through an interactive web space, the tool introduces students to elements of design and lets them experience principles of design which they've learned in the classes. Learning takes place through exploring examples, studying how elements behave, as well as reading through concepts. So let us now have a look at the Elements of Design tool.
Elements of Design is a design learning tool developed by IDC IIT Bombay. This is an interactive web space where students and aspiring designers can learn about the basics of design. The tool's overview shows us the interrelation between point, line, plane, and volume. A point is the smallest element of design. Multiple points form a line. Joining various lines form planes. And multiple planes form a voluminous object. Point, line, plane, and volume thus form the elements of design.
The elements have certain visual features like
shape, size, position, orientation, texture, and color. Together, these form the visual features. Understanding these well is helpful for studying and applying the principles of design. Principles of design represent the accumulated wisdom of researchers and practitioners in design and related fields. They are the fundamental guidelines for making an effective and pleasurable design.
A designer has to use these principles in combinations to make a piece which functions and communicates clearly and effectively. In our tool, we learn about principles of design through two categories, structural and relational. All principles related to construction of a design are included in structural principles. This section includes concepts such as negative and positive space, figure and ground, alignment, symmetry, proportion, repetition, grids, illusion, and framing. All principles that are relative, that is, need another element to be compared with, are included in relational principles. This section includes concepts such as movement, depth, hierarchy, order, sequence, balance, emphasis, unity, contrast, and variety. Let's see how to navigate through the tool. To select an element, go to the left panel. This panel has icons of point, line, planes, and volumes. Plane expands to three basic planes, square, triangle, and circle, while volume expands to cube, cone, and sphere. You can study visual features and all the principles of design using each of these elements. You can also focus on one concept and study how each element behaves. For example, movement can be studied by studying movement of point, movement of line, of all the three basic planes, and of all the three basic volumes. On the right, we have a View All button, which lets you view the entire concept with all its visuals all at once. To the extreme right is the No More section. You can read through this section for detailed information on a concept. Each of our interactions are designed in a way that they make every concept simple and easy to understand. They are also backed with regular annotations to explain the reason behind each step. Elements of Design can be a demonstrative tool for teachers to introduce the basics of design. For beginner design students, it can play a role of being a self-study tool or a revision tool. For an aspiring designer, it can be the first step to learning design. You can experience the Elements of Design tool on dsource.in or on the Dsource app available on the Play Store as well as the App Store. Happy learning!